I'm sorry, I was trying to put Hank to sleep, and I heard your message come in, and now that I know you're okay, I'm feeling a little bit ridiculous right now. Glad you're back on the grid, whatever that means. I love you. Catch up soon.
James, thank heavens you made it in time. There's a storm heading this way within the hour, and I need you to plow right into the center of it.
Of course you do. Do I want to know why?
I need to attach sensors to your rig's winch, so time is of the essence. I'll explain while you're on your way to the top of Shaq's Peak. All right then, get in your rig. I'll fill you in as we go.
You should see coordinates on your HUD based on where I expect the eye of the storm. Get moving.
So what's the skinny, Doc? Since when are we storm chasers?
Since I heard every crewman at Coronis buzzing about the big quest for pure T energy. While that fool Kenny is playing mad scientist with the A-grid, he's utterly failed to see the storm patterns for the clue they are. If Braddock had just bought me some more time with Nevik, I'd have been able to prove there's low impurity T energy within the storms, and lots of it. If storm is even the right word for them. The storms don't fit any natural weather pattern I've seen. They come and go so quickly, with none of the wind signature you'd expect of an Emperor-class atmospheric disturbance. It's as if they somehow have a trajectory.
They do seem to come out of nowhere.
No, James, just the opposite.
Oh, Doc, you may be blowing my mind a little here.
A perennial danger. But with your help, it's time to stop guessing and start hoarding data. Those custom sensors I installed on your winch are going to run a host of tests to help us figure out precisely what we're dealing with once and for all. With a little luck, we'll find some way to help Corona stay standing in the process.
All right. Not like it'll be the craziest thing I do today.
Cargo successfully docked. Thank you.
Okay, Doc, I'm in position. And looks like I'm right on time.
Fire your winch at the tower and give it some time to collect the data. Your rig's going to act like a grounded relay for lightning. Don't worry, you should be safe.
Doc, we got company. Flyers. And they're swatting at the winch like a cat toy.
That's no good, James. You've got to keep the sensors safe until they finish.
Can't do much from in here. Seems calm enough on the ground, though. Eye of the storm, right? Wish me luck.
Good luck. Don't fly off.
Something strange about these acrid. They're different from the others I've seen. A different hue. Lighter, maybe.
Well, don't forget to use your DNA tagger on them. They could be part of this puzzle, too. James, we've got what we need in there. Get back in your rig and get out of there.
With pleasure.
Cargo tram is docked and ready.
James, come look at the contaminant readings. They're practically non-existent. This may be the purest reading we've ever seen. The prize Coronis is looking for is in the very thing trying to knock them down a crevasse.
You're telling me these storms are somehow powered by the purest tea energy on the planet? You sure that's good news?
Good or bad remains to be seen. But if we find where the storms are coming from...
Maybe we find the mother load of pure tea energy. And while Nevek uses it to solve the energy crisis on Earth, we get rich and get home.
Sure. And also lay eyes on one of the rarest, most mysterious wonders of the universe. If you're into that sort of thing.
Yeah, totally. That too.
I'll take some time to fully parse all the data we just took in. I'll let you know what comes of it. Meanwhile, I hate to send you off empty-handed.
Gale here. I got that part repaired for you if you want to come pick it up now. It was a bitch.
Thank you. I'm Nerissa Rock.
And I'm Arthur Beagle. You're listening to GPR, Galactic Public Radio, broadcasting and podcasting around the solar system, thanks to the generous support of Neo Venus Construction and listeners like you.
On tonight's broadcast, a look back at the Kettleman mining colony 30 years after the depletion.
Quarterly energy figures are out. Is the crisis worsening?
And austerity riots continue to spread. What protesters are demanding now?
All this and more on tonight's All in All.
Hey, what's the rumpus, Jim? Gail got you rummaging around for scrap, huh? That ammo adds severe burn damage if you can hit them acrid sweet spots. Their blood just ignites and stays. See yous around.
Here you go, dude. Thanks for helping me keep my ancient water purifier controller skills sharp. Cool. What do we get to do today? You can never have too much hull shielding, right? Actually, any more than this and you might fall over, so that might be too much. Doodles.
Welcome back. Gail got you rummaging around for scrap.
Good deal, good deal. You be careful out there, kiddo.
Busting out the welding goggles. Yep. More reach for your wind. Doodles.
And he says, without a trace of irony, "Oh, you must be the weather girl." So I'm staring daggers. He knows he stepped in it, but he's too daft to figure out why. "Oh, sorry, weather woman?" Finally, I say, "Well, my doctorate's in atmospheric sciences, so yeah, I'm the bleeding weather girl, thanks." I'm dry, poor me.
Thank you.